Hey there, Ruby Chocolate. Fancy Vanilla Beans. What you doing? Here, sit down.
Okay.
You know, I'm just looking at this fashion rag and thinking of ideas for my ever-growing wardrobe.
Oh, okay. Well,
I like this one.
Yeah? Why do you like this one?
'Cause he looks like a soft brown bunny.
You know, Ruby Chocolate, you have quite an eye for fashion. Did anyone ever tell you that?
No, but Miss Bettina says that I'm as sweet as pie.
And I agree with Miss Bettina. You are a good little bunny, but there must be something you have a real talent for, right?
Well, maybe. I'm not sure what it could be, though.
I have a fantastic idea.
Let's do a talent show.
I know what my talent is, creating fashion looks.
Ruby, let's announce this to everyone and give you a chance to show off your talents.
Okay, if you think so.
You know, Vanilla Beans, I'm not a prop.
Oh, you did a great job, though.
Today, we're doing a talent show. I've never done one before. It's Miss Bean's idea. You know, she has so much natural charisma and showmanship. I just know she'll go first and she'll set the standard for the rest of us.
I know what my talent will be, but, well, I'm a little nervous. But I'm ready. Ready as I'll ever be.
You might as well get started. Ruby, where are you?
Where are you? Ruby.
Oh, there you are. You ready?
I guess so.
Oh, Miss Bettina. You ready, honey?
I'm as ready as I'll ever be, darling. Just tell me when it's my turn.
Great. Everyone ready?
I was born ready.
Sure. I guess so.
Let's do this.
Okay, then. Miss Beans, I leave this endeavor to your capable little white paws.
May I?
You may, sir.
All right, ladies and gentlemen,
welcome to the first annual Attic Talent Show, featuring talent from everyone in this corner of the attic. And first we have me. You're too kind. So, let's see. Next, we have Mr. Rabbit Warren.
Okay, my friends. I want to share with you why I used to be called Bendy Rabbit.
Okay. Ta-da! Oh, you're too kind. Well, next we have Penny Lick. Take it away. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Alright, here's, lizard brain.
Anti-disestablishmentarianism. Anti-disestablishmentarianism. Again, that is the longest word that, well, that I know. I'm sure there are more, but anyway. Yes, so next we have Bettina. Miss Bettina, take it away.
Miss Bettina? Miss Bettina?
Hey kids, I'm gonna stay over here in this dark corner if you don't mind. Because I got a story to tell you.
Now listen well, my children. For this is a story about a bad little boy and what he learned one day. You see, just on one side of town, there was a little old lady. And she lived in a big old house. You see, the kids in town thought she was a witch. She lived alone.
Well, she lived alone except for 15 cats.
Now, those kids in town were afraid of her, but there was one little boy, a bad little boy. He wasn't afraid of the little old lady.
And he thought it would be fun to throw rocks at her house. The other kids watched him do this, and he threw a rock right through that window. Those children all ran screaming down the dark street, back into their own homes. But the cats escaped through the open window. And that night, the cats went hunting.
And the next day, the bad little boy opened up his front door to see a pile of dead mice, rats, birds, and lizards on his porch.
He told his parents that the witch did it, and they called on that little old lady
and they demanded to know why she killed so many little creatures and piled them on their property.
She said, "I didn't do anything of the sort. Your kid broke my window and the cats escaped." You know, house cats are an invasive species. They should not be let outside all the time because it affects the food chain.
And the little boy had to apologize and he had to fix that old lady's window. And he vowed he would never throw rocks at windows again. Or let the cats outside.
The end.
Miss Bettina, thank you for those storytelling escapades.
It certainly had some imagery.
Why, thank you, darling. It was the oldest story I know. I hope you liked it.
I mean, it really was good. I liked it.
Oh, bless it. Pennylick, why don't you put her down for her nap?
And last but certainly not least, my little sister, Ruby Chocolate! Ruby Chocolate!
Psst, psst! Rabbit Warren!
I don't have any talents.
Oh, Ruby.
That's not true. You're talented at being adorable.
Yeah, Ruby. You also give everyone nice hugs. You're the cuddliest one.
Oh, yes, I say, you're the glue that holds us together, Ruby.
And you're the sweetest little friend.
Not to mention, second only to me when it comes to being a fashionista.
Don't you see, Ruby?
You are the cutest, cuddliest, friendliest, sweetest,
huggiest,
glueiest, and fashionablest one here.
And I say, my little sister, Ruby Chocolate,
is the winner of the talent show.
Years long, there were mountains in our way, but we climbed the stairs every day. Love is